Hi everyone, my name is Godfrey and welcome to my YouTube channel where I give you tips on how to come to Germany as a professional. I studied veterinary medicine in Uganda and I moved to Germany last year in October to be able to work as a veterinary doctor in Germany. And I'm going to be giving you tips on how to come to Germany, how you can manage the paperwork, and how you can finally make it here as a professional. Now, you may ask yourself questions like, why would I need to come to Germany? Why would I need to go to Germany to work there? Why Germany, you know? Now, you need to find out that yourself. I would advise you to go on the internet and find out things about how much. It doesn't matter what you studied. Maybe you studied accounting, social work, computer engineering, human medicine, animal medicine. Just go out on the internet and find out how much money does an accountant in your country earn and an accountant in Germany, and you compare the two, then you will know that probably if it's worth it to come to Germany, then you probably will earn a little bit more money, slightly above average, or so there are just a lot of opportunities. And then there is also, in Germany, every employee has health insurance, which is paid partly by the employer and partly by the person who is working, the employee. So, and when you're sick, I mean, you go to the hospital and you don't have to pay anything, only in exceptional cases, maybe complex surgeries and so on. So these are all good things. That the salary is a little bit higher compared to, not all countries, but compared to a few countries, maybe in Africa, South America, Middle East, Asia. So you could probably be able to earn a little bit more salary, a better salary, I would say, in Germany. So those are some of the reasons. And also in Germany, there are just many jobs. You know, maybe you did your degree in your home country and you can't find a job there, but there are always open opportunities in Germany. You can come in and you could easily find a job here, you know? So those are some of the reasons. And you could have other reasons. There could be, you just wanna experience or have international experience for your work or for your profession. So you could just come to Germany and get that experience. But the seven tips that I want to give you are, number one, so before you think about coming to Germany to work, first of all, you need to find out, is your degree recognized in Germany? So before you take any other step, go onto the internet. There is a site called ANABIN. In German, they call it Hochschulabschlüsse ANABIN something. Or you can just type in into Google and you're like, hey, recognizable degrees in Germany. And then there is a list for every country. You can click on your country and then you'll find out which university in your country, which university has degrees that are recognized in Germany. And your degree should be on that list. Otherwise, you don't start the process. And then number two, you need to check that you have money, because this process is not, it's not very expensive, but it's also not very cheap. So you need to check that you have enough money either on your account or in cash to take you through the whole process. Now for my case, my whole process from A to Z, beginning to work as a, so working on my whole visa process to be able to come here until I got my work permit as a veterinary doctor, it costed me around 2,000 euros, everything, including the language courses, the visa fees, the flights, and everything. So it's very, very important that you check that you have enough money that's gonna take you through this process. Otherwise, you may start, and then you lose the other money, stop on the way. So check that you have enough money. Think through the whole process, because there are many expenses along the way, sending papers to German, sending them back, translating your papers, getting them certified. It can cost somehow a lot of money. So find out how much money you have and if you have enough money to take you through the whole process. That's number two. And then number three, if you're a person who is considering to come to Germany, then you need to learn the German language. You need to learn this language. I have been talking to people back home and they think, I can speak English, so I can make it in German. No way. The official language in this country is German. And if you want to have an easy life here, you need to learn the language. Now, there are many institutions that teach this language. In Africa, there is almost in every single country, if not all, there is Goethe Institute. So you can go to Goethe Institute, you can study the language, and you can do up to B2, because if you want to work here, you need a German language level, which is up to B2. Now you may ask me, what is B2? So there are six language levels usually, and that is A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2. But to work in Germany, you need at least B2. And that is a language level which is slightly above average. And with this B2 language level, the German government expects you to be able to handle 80% of your everyday experiences or situations, like at work, maybe you're at a train station, maybe you go to the hospital, you should be able to write emails, you should be able to call hospitals to make appointments and so on. That's with B2. So that's the level you need, and start as soon as possible. If you realize that you're interested in coming to work in Germany, please start with the language because it's also a requirement. You will not be given the permit without these language certificates. So that's number one. And number four, that's number three. And number four, you need to get your documents certified. All the documents that you're gonna send in into, like, for your degree, to be given the work permit in Germany, all your documents have to be certified. Now, you can either send them in German to be certified, or you can certify them at the German embassy in your respective country. And for my case, that's what I did. It costs around 20 euros, and I took them there and they put them together. They put a stamp and put a sticker from the embassy, and then you have your documents certified. Or you can, if you cannot do that, you can send them to Germany to a professional translator, and they call them beglaubigte Übersetzer. So you send them in, they translate them for you. I mean, that is after. So you send in your documents to be translated after they have been certified. And when so you can make a deal usually with the private translators, the certified translators of your documents, that immediately they finish translating them, they can send them to you, they can send them directly to the German government that is responsible for issuing work permits or issuing probation work permits, you know. And for that, you need to go and find out where your papers need to be sent, because in Germany it's like the United States, because they have states. In German, they call them Bundesländer, and every Bundesland has its own government, and every government is responsible for working on these papers. So for me, in the state where I am, it's called Bavaria. In German, they call it Bayern, but it's Bavaria in English. And I sent my papers to the Bavarian government, and that's where my papers were processed, and that's where my work permit was also issued. To be my allowance to practice veterinary medicine in this country. And then, so that you need to find out yourself. And now, when you send the papers in, it can take up to 6 months until you get the response, until you get the, in German, they call it approbation. So it's like a probational practicing license of whatever you studied. And for me, as a veterinary doctor, this probational permit is valid for 4 years, but for other professions, it can be 3 years. Human medicine is 3 years, and for other professionals, it could be 2 years, 1 year. I don't know. You need to find out how long your profession takes. And then when you get it, it's only after when you get that approbation, which is the probational work permit, then that you can be given a work visa. So when you get it, the government where you sent in the things, they will send it back to you. And then this approbation is a prerequisite for getting the visa at the German embassy in your respective countries. So then you start the process of applying for the visa. Because now, but the tricky part about the visa, which you should not forget, is that German gives out only two kinds of visas. It gives out the visitor's visa and the long stay visa. And the long stay visa, the short stay visa is a visa which is up to 90 days. So you're allowed to visit German for up to 90 days. And then the long stay visa is a visa which you can stay in German longer than 90 days. And this can be a marriage visa, it can be a study visa, it can be a work visa, it can be a job seeker's visa, or anything. Anything that is not a visitor's visa is a long stay visa. Now, to get a long stay visa, you need to have 10,000 euros on your account. Otherwise, they don't give it to you, because the German government wants to make sure that you can take care of your financial problems when you're in Germany. And if you don't have this 10,000 euros, there is another option. You need to have a German national who can write for you a letter that they are going to take care of you until you start to work. Now, this letter in German is called Verpflichtungserklärung. And if they can write for you this letter, then you don't need the 10,000 euros. But if you don't have this letter, then you need 10,000 euros. That's around 10,900 US dollars. And it has to be on a locked German account, strictly. You cannot just put it on your account in your countries or whatever. It has to be on a locked account so that they are sure that when you come to Germany, you can access that money only when you're in Germany. Because many people will just get money from somewhere, put it on their account, and then they come. So those are the 7 tips, and I hope they have been helpful. And if you find this video helpful, please don't forget to like it, put a thumbs up, and also you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I'm going to be doing more videos which will help you in your process of coming to Germany. So thank you very much, and yeah, thank you so very, very much for watching. And I'm going to make next week another video about the problems of being in Germany. Now that you are in Germany, which other problems could you experience? Which challenges could you experience? So wait, and thank you for watching. Big up. Bye.